Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and these are the major app updates for the first week of May 2022. Now the first app that was updated is Apple's Support app. If you use Apple's Support app, this can be super helpful if maybe you have a problem with your device, and this is now updated to support AppleCare Plus for Business Essentials. Apple rolled out Business Essentials not long ago, and they've now added it if you have a device that uses that. Also, they've enhanced performance and added some bug fixes as well. Gmail gets an update, and this is helpful if you use focus modes. So if you have the latest version of Gmail, you can now tell it what important emails actually come through in your focus modes. So under settings in focus, you now have the option to add Gmail, and then you can customize this to allow those notifications to come through depending on the focus mode that you have active. So that's something you can do with the latest version of Gmail. So not a huge update there, but at least it's super helpful if you're using Gmail as your default email. So that's something that I think has been lacking for a while that they finally updated. Now, if you're using Google Maps, they've updated this as well. There's a couple things to note. The first thing is iOS 13.3 is no longer supported with Google Maps. So if you're using Google Maps, which I actually have here, we'll go down to Maps. And if we're using Google Maps, they're no longer supporting iOS 13.3. So you would need 13.4 or later. So that's kind of an odd change, but something that they've updated it with. Photos can now be displayed on the map. You can turn this off under your personal content. So if we go into Google Maps, within your timeline, you'll actually see different photos, and you can actually turn this off if you don't want it displayed in Maps, or also when you're using Apple CarPlay, you can see this also. So if you go into your profile and tap on settings, under settings and under personal content, you now have Google Photos. So you can turn this off if you don't want it showing up in your timeline, whether that be here or in CarPlay. Small update, but something that's a little bit different. The Xbox app gets an update. So if we go into Xbox, and if you have an Xbox account or Microsoft account, you can go into the Xbox app, tap on your library, and there you'll see all of your different game captures and things. Maybe you took a screenshot or maybe just a clip of a game you saved while you were playing on Xbox. Tap on that clip or screenshot. Now you can share it out. Now this is available in Australia also now, and you'll have the option to share that directly from your phone. So you can share that to other people on Xbox or also copy a link and send it to a friend. So that's something they've updated recently. Now you may have already heard the big news that Fortnite is now available to play on iPhone and iPad using iOS or iPadOS. However, it's not a direct app. Rather, it's through Microsoft's Xbox Cloud Gaming Service. Now the nice thing is they announced this is free. You don't need an Xbox Live subscription. You just need a Microsoft account. So if you sign up for a Microsoft account, then an Epic account to play Fortnite, you can do that. Now I've created an app link just using the actual website from Safari, and I'll share that in the description so you can just jump right to it. But if you tap on this icon here, just go to the website, you'll see the same thing I'm seeing here. Once you're signed in, you'll see the option for Fortnite. This will actually stream, so you don't need to install the app or anything like that. You can just play it directly through here. So if I tap on this, you'll see it says Cloud Gaming Beta. Tap on Fortnite. It takes a moment to load. It connects through the internet, and now it's loading on my phone. So we'll give it just a moment to connect. Now you'll see it's loaded, and this is really dependent on your internet connection. So as long as you have a good internet connection, you'll be able to play it. So you'll see I'm on the main screen here. It's running. We can switch between different things, just like we had the app native on the device itself. So now you'll be able to use that, and anyone can use it as long as you sign up for that account. So that's great. Let me know if you play Fortnite in the comments below. Now, if you use a password manager, 1Password got a major update, at least on the Mac side. So if you use 1Password, this is a password management app that's really nice. They've actually updated it to version 8 for Mac. It has a redesigned interface and improved watchtower. So what they actually say about it is that it features a sleeker and more intuitive design. The next generation of 1Password for Mac helps users manage and protect their most sensitive information. New and enhanced functionalities, including improved performance, security, and speed, reinforces users' productivity to help them get more done faster, whether at work or at home. So that's updated now. You can download that if you want to try it out. It is a paid app, but it's a great app if you're trying to manage passwords. Now, Spotify gets a minor update as well, and this actually improves performance issues on iOS. So I mentioned it just because I know some people were having performance issues with it. So if you're not using Apple Music, Spotify actually should perform much better than it was before. Now, Twitter gets an update for some users. Now, first of all, many people are asking, how do I have a black Twitter icon? Well, that's because I actually subscribe to Twitter Blue. If you do that, you get additional features, but you also have the option to change through different icons. So you can change this between multiple things. So let me show you that. So if you have Twitter Blue, just go to app icon, and then there's some app icons. So I can change them to any of these. They have limited edition icons that change throughout the month sometimes. So you'll see this one's available until May 31st. So if I change it to this one, you'll see that it's changed. And also they're updating a new feature called Twitter Circle. This is very similar to what reminds me of Google Plus, and it allows you to add people in your circle that are close friends, up to 150 of them. This is rolling out slowly. I personally don't have it yet, but it's something you'll be able to see in the future. So maybe we'll see it for everyone soon, or maybe they'll just get rid of it altogether if it doesn't work out for them and not a lot of people use it. With the latest TikTok update, they've actually added a feature where you can actually share your effects with friends. So if you create a video with your effects in it, you can share those effects directly with friends. According to TikTok, you can see here, you can use your video as a way to announce and publicize your effect, demonstrate to viewers how your effect can be used, prompt viewers to create their own videos using your effect, and start a trend by showing how your effect can be used. So that's something that they've updated within TikTok if you have the latest version. Now there's an app called Camo you may or may not be familiar with. This app allows you to connect your iPhone to a Mac and use it as a webcam. So maybe you have an older Mac with a bad webcam, or maybe you have a newer Mac, but the actual webcam isn't that great on some of them. You can use your iPhone's webcam directly for that. They've updated this now to support and use your iPhone as a webcam in FaceTime, Safari, and QuickTime apps officially. So you'll see you just connect this to your Mac and you'll be able to do that. So this is a great application if you have an older Mac specifically, or just maybe even one of the latest ones where the camera isn't good enough for you. So the app was free. There are paid options within it, but the app itself is free. If you use Ulysses for writing, it's been updated to version 26. So if you go into Ulysses, they've updated this on Mac to add a permanently visible counter in the corner, but on iOS and iPadOS, they've optimized the flow for publishing blog posts. They've also added a dedicated publishing menu and publishing preview. So if you want to publish directly from here, you can do that. And then also they've modernized it with the WordPress integration using WordPress REST API. So if you want to use Ulysses to manage maybe a post you're putting on your website, you can do that more easily now. So that's been updated, and the update's free if you already subscribe to it. You may need to subscribe to have some of those publishing features though. In addition to that, we're still waiting for an iOS update to come out to the public. For quite some time, I thought that Apple was going to release iOS 15.4.2 to the public. So far, we haven't seen them release that. So along with all those app updates, I expect a public update fairly soon to address bug fixes and maybe security concerns. However, Apple is still working on iOS 15.5 betas at the time of this video, and we can expect a few more of those with probably a public release toward the end of the month. So that's what we're waiting for with iOS updates. Hopefully we'll see more about that very, very soon. As far as any additional app updates, well, those are the major ones this week. But if there's any apps that you use regularly that you'd love for me to cover weekly in these app updates, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.